Good evening. Today we are going to discuss regarding 802.11 block act. This is the topic of today's. So in the content part, we are going to look introduction, then what are the types, what kind of frames we are going to use, how does the message sequence chart are going to look into. Then what are the different phases like setup phase, data and blockic phase, then immediate versus delayed blockic, then what else phases are there like tear down phase, then what are the kind of frames we are going to use. So they are the different kinds of frames. So one by one we are going to discuss. So this block ACK, block acknowledgement, in short we can say it as BA. This is initially defined in IEEE 802.11 E standard as an optional scheme. So basic purpose of this 802.11 E is to improve the MAC efficiency. 802.11n amendment, basically it was ratified in the year 2009, and this block ACK mechanism, they made it as mandatory in this 802.11n specification. So it was supported by 802.11n capable devices. 802.11n, basically we call it as high throughput devices. So high throughput is nothing but HT. So what happens, instead of transforming the individual acknowledgement for each and every MPDU at a time, acknowledgement together using a single block ACK. So let's say I'm a courier guy and I do have 10 packets to deliver you. I brought the van to your doorstep and I would like to deliver all the 10 packets to you. Instead of doing one by one packet, initially I will take one packet, I will deliver to you. Again, I will come back to the van, I will take the second one. Similarly, I will go for third one, fourth one, like that if I will go. Instead of that, what I will do, I will take all the 10 things, I will deliver it to you, and finally I will take the acknowledgement, yes, things are got delivered to me, then I will come back. So in this whole process, what will happen, instead of going, coming, I will go at a time and I will deliver all the things to you and come back. So overally, in this total process, the timing matters a lot, right? So this block ACK contains the bitmap size of 64 into 16. So basically this is these bits are 60 bits accounts the fragment number of the MPDUs to be acknowledged. Each bit of this bitmap represents the status, I mean success or failure, of each MPD. So this block ACK mechanism improves the channel efficiency. How does it efficiency? By doing aggregating several acknowledgements into the frame, into basically one frame. So these are the block ACK types. Broadly, it is classified into two types. The first one is immediate block ACK, and the second one is delayed block ACK. This immediate block ACK, basically this is suitable for the higher bandwidth, low latency traffic, while the opponent one, that is delayed block ACK, this is suitable for moderate latency traffic. Block ACK procedure totally consists of setup and tear down of the session phase. So basically what happens in the setup phase, capability information such as what is the buffer size, what kind of block ACK policy These are the things we are going to negotiate with the server. Once the setup phase is completed, the transmitter can send frames without waiting for the acknowledgement frame. And finally, the block accession is going to go down. Here we are going to see what kind of frames used. So basically, there are two types of frames we are going to use here in the blocking process. First one is BAR, that is block acknowledgement request, and the second one is block acknowledgement. Request an acknowledgement to the recipient station, confirming that he or she has received a blocking of frames. Block acknowledgement request is used. Let's say I am going to deliver some packets to you. So when I'm going to deliver all the 10 packets, instead of asking the acknowledgement, hey, whether you received the first one, whether you received the second one, what I will do after delivering all the 10 packets, I will ask you, did you receive all the 10 packets? So in return, you can say that, yes, I got the 10 packets. The request procedure, whatever I'm making, that's what called the block acknowledgement request. In short, we are going to say it as BAR. And the response what you are going to give me, that's what we call is block acknowledgement, BA. That is used for response. So basically, this is a message sequence chart, which we call it a block message sequence chart. Here you can say, on the first part is setup, I will take the laser pointer. So here you can see this is the setup phase, and the second one is the data and blocking mechanism, the sequence happening, and the final is teardown phase. So here we're going to discuss one by one. And the blocking mechanism initiated by exchanging of ADVAR request or response frames. So ADVAR request means add blocking request. That's what called. In short, it's ADVA, you can say. After initialization, blocks of QS data frames may be transmitted from the originator to the recipient. The MPDUs within the block of frames are acknowledged by the blocking frame. Okay. This is the blocking frame. Here you can see, which was requested by blocking request frame. This is the blocking request frame. So blocking. See here what happens. After exchanging of ADVAR request, when ACK came, then ADVAR response, ACK came. So here the setup phase is done. After that, the data exchange will happen. Blocking request, blocking will happen. Then DELVA request, ACK. The final one is DELVA, means delete blocking request. So this is called teardown process. Coming to setup phase. Transmitter station, which we call it as originator, first checks whether the intended recipient station, which is the destination, is capable of participating in blocking mechanism by discovering and examining its delayed blocking and immediate blocking capability bits. Okay. If the intended recipient station is capable of participating, the originator sends an ADVA request, ADDBA, add BA request frame indicating that the TID for which the blocking is being set up. So these are the steps it's going to use. Then the recipient station will respond with an add BA response frame. And the recipient station has the option of it may accept, it may reject. So when the recipient station accepts, then the blocking agreement exists between the originator and the recipient. after setup phase, this data and blocking phase is going to happen. The originator may transmit a block of US data frames, which is going to separate by SIFS periods, sort into frame space. This is called SIFS, means sort into frame space. So with the total number of frames not exceeding the buffer size subfield. So what do you mean by buffer size? Is at the time of agreement, they're going to send a buffer size. So whenever this data frame is going to happen, so it has to be within buffer size. It should not exceed the buffer size. Okay. So each of the frames shall have the acknowledgement policy subfield, the cost control field set to block it. This is contained. So the originator requests acknowledgement of outstanding cost data frames by sending a basic blocker request. After this exchange of data, the originator has to send the blocker request frame to the recipient. The recipient shall maintain a blocker record for the block. So this is how we can going to differentiate between immediate versus detailed blocker policy. So first of all, we will look to the immediate blocking policy. Here what happens, this is the originator, this is the recipient, setup phase is done, then all the data frames it's going to send by the originator, cost data, QS data, QS data, then it's going to send the blocking request. Once the recipient is going to send the blocking request, recipient has to acknowledge with the basic blocking. Okay. The typical blocking sequence with the immediate policy used. Here, immediately, once the blocking request received by recipient, it's respond with the blocking. But here you can see, same thing happened. Here, after the cost data, basic blocking request, but after some time, only normal egg came, then after some time, the basic blocking, that is acknowledgement, the blocking came. So it got delayed a little bit here. So that's the reason the name here used as delayed blocking. Here the tear down phase. So once the data exchange will happen, it has to tear down. Tear down means the setup, connection has to be closed. So when the originator has no data to send and final block exchange has completed, it shall signal the end of its use of the block mechanism by sending the del buffer frame to its recipient. That is del block, delete block and block acknowledgement frame. So there is no management response frame from the recipient. The recipient of the Delva frame shall release all resources allocated for the blocking transfer. The blocking agreement may be torn down if there is no blocking request or QS data of the blocking transaction IDs received from the PO within a duration of blocking timeout value. So here you can see, this is the blocking request frame, this is the blocking. Okay. Now we are going to discuss in detail about each and every frame here. This is a add BA request frame. So here you can see, this is the add blocking request frame. This is the frame number 284, it seems. Yeah, 284. And the type is, this is an action frame. And here you can see the blocking is written. Okay. So it is an, this is a management action frame. Action category is the 3 and the action code is 0. So these are the things it's mentioned over here. I'm going to show you action category. Okay. So this is the action category code. The with block ACK is 3 and the action code is 0. You can find these frames by using the following WISAC display filters. Here it's completely wrote in green and you can use it. The dialog token field is set to a non-zero value chosen by the station. This is the dialog token field. So the block ACK timeout value field is of 2 byte. This is the block ACK timeout value. And it is used in the add BA request and response frames to indicate the timeout value for block ACK. Block ACK parameters. Here you can see the block ACK parameters one by one. The block ACK parameter set field is used in add BA frames to signal the parameters for setting up a block ACK. So if you look at the length of the block ACK parameters, it's of 2 byte. So the first one is AMSDU supported. Basically, it determines whether AMSDU may be carried in QS data, MPDU sent under this block ACK agreement. When it's equal to 1, AMSDU is permitted. When it's set to 0, it means that AMSDU is not permitted. Here it's completely written. This is the block parameter fields. Block ACK policy. If it is set to 1, immediate block ACK. Set to 0 means delayed block ACK. And this is the transaction ID. This contains the value of the transaction ID for which the block ACK is being requested. Finally, the buffer size. It indicates the number of buffers available for this particular transaction ID. So this is in total 16 bits, that is 2 bytes, B0 to B15. Add BA response frame. So this is also a management frame with the category 0 and the action code is 1, whereas in the previous one it was 0. If you look at this, action code was block ACK, the category code was 3 and the action code was 0. Coming to this, here the category is 3, but action code is 1. And similarly, the status code 0 means it is add BA request accepted by recipient station, that is successful. And here the dialog token value has to be copied from the add BA request frame. The same thing. Similarly, you can find these frames by using the following filters in WhatsApp display. Block ACK request frame. So this is the block ACK request frame. Here you can see. So once the originator sends block of frames, it is requesting recipient to acknowledge them. The recipient has to acknowledge. The request is done by sending a block ACK request frame. So this is nothing but block ACK request, BAR, which is a control frame. Frame format of block ACK request. So this is in detail of the block ACK request frame. This block ACK request frame sent under the delayed and HT delayed agreements. So the block ACK request acknowledgement policy subfield of the block ACK control field has the meaning shown in table here. Here you can go in detail. Completely it's mentioned. So this block ACK request frame sent under the other types of agreement the blocking request ACK policy, so field is resolved. Here the fields are resolved, you can see. Blocking request frame. The blocking frame sent by the recipient station. This is the recipient to the originator. Here the pictorial diagram, you can see. So what are the multiple TID subfield value? What are the things it's containing? We already saw in the previous slides. So basic block A, compressed block A, the value is going to, for the basic block A, the value is going to set for 0. Compressed block A is 1, reserve is 0. And the multi-transaction ID block A is 1. And this is the sniffer capture. This is for block A, and the type is 1, subtype is 9. Everything you can see it here. It's clearly mentioned. And how does this block A frame looks like? We saw already. So this block A frame sent under delayed and ST block A, ST delayed agreements. The block A policy subfield of the block A control field has the meaning shown in table 8. So here it's mentioned. What is normal acknowledgement? What is no acknowledgement? Okay. So for block A frames sent under other types of agreements, the block A policy subfield is resolved. Del BA frame, delete block A request. So again, these are the categories, orders, and these are the information. This del BA frame is sent by either side. The originator may send, the recipient may send. So basically the purpose of this frame is to terminate the block A participation. The action frame of del BA frame format contains the information as shown in the diagram. Okay, so for today, that's all from my side. You can question me, you can comment me. Thank you. Thank you so much, guys. Bye.